OK， 首先我要感谢所有的记者朋友今天到来我们的这一个记者会，就是今天26号3月26号的这一个记者会。然后在我旁边的这一位是这一个公民与社会运动主任邢志立律师，然后我本身就是马青发言人李议员。So today, first of all, a very warm welcome to all the reporters, to all the reporter friends, and thank you for coming to our press conference in such a short notice. And first of all, we would like to start off by introducing ourselves. Myself is MCA Youth Spokesperson Li Yuan, and right beside me is the Youth Civil and Society Movement Bureau Chief, Heng Zi Li Lawyer. So today we will start our press conference in Chinese.And then afterwards, we'll start with the English. So, okay. 通过昨天的这一个报章啊，我们看到就是这一个国会已经在2018年的时候已经修宪，降低这一个投票年龄了，为18岁。选举委员会却在昨天宣布，基于行动管制令的原因，把这项政策展延至明年9月才落实。针对这一个选举委员会的这项决定，马庆认为是完全不合理及荒谬的。为什么？第一个，选举委员会所给予的理由让人难以理解。首先，选举委员会如何预知在下一届大选进行之前的同时，如果国内依然实行着行动管制令，他如何能够知道下一届大选是几时呢？或者是为什么会放在明年9月才落实呢？其次，选举委员会所要进行的是选民册的这一个编排工作，请问这跟行动管制令有任何的关系吗？有，为什么行动管制令或者是这一个疫情会影响到他们落实这项政策呢？难道行动管制令的这一个 SOP 禁止这一个选举委员会进行他们的工作吗？这是完全不合逻辑的。第二点，修宪允许18岁投票是通过国会一致决定的，获得朝野政党当时的支持，也反映了大部分的年轻人需要这项政策落实，可以表达他们自己的声音。选举委员会的责任就是尽快落实这项决定，而不是一再拖延。所谓的辩论适不适合、合不合适、应不应该，那个已经是过去式了。今天选举委员会要做的只是执行以落实这项政策。第三，选举委员会的这个副主席 Dr. Azmi 曾经在3月10号说过，尽管面对新冠肺炎的这一个疫情还有这一个行动管制令，但是落实18岁投票以及自动登记成为选民的已经是在 on schedule， 已经是根据这一个行程而定，也是意思就是说不会受到展延，而且预计今年7月就准备就绪了。这一项最新的宣布，由选举委员会的这个主席宣布，明显与自己本身的这个副主席的言论是自相矛盾的。所以我们希望这个选举委员会出面澄清这项言论。还有，在针对18岁选民。成为18岁年轻人成为选民自动登记为选民的这项政策，马青的是非常非常认同这项政策，尤其是我们应该让更多的年轻人18岁以上的年轻人参与国家的这个建设，参与国家的这个政治。为什么呢？因为年轻人就是国家的希望，所以我们希望更多年轻人能够参与国家的这个政治。我们不应该用莫无虚有的理由来抹杀他们原本能够投票的这一个权利，所以我们希望选举委员会尽快的根据他们所设定的这一个日期实行这项政策。年轻人本身就是为了他们的权，他们应该要有投票权来为他们的权益而抗争。所以我们在这里，我们也要表达，年轻人本身其实没有很明显的这一个政治投票倾向，而且自动成为选民也能让更多的在马来西亚的公民参与这一个政治，因为政治和政府的组成与他们的生活习惯、日常跟他们的日常是息息相关的。所以我们希望就是在这个选举委员会能够认真的对待这件事情， 更重要的是，我们如果让这一个年轻选民，就是18岁以上能够投票的话，更容易让他们能够争取他们自己本身的权益。就例如我们看到西蒙之前的这一个承诺，废除 BTPDN 之后，当了政府却没有废除这一个 BTPDN， 为什么呢？可能他们觉得这一个年轻选票，因为年轻人没有选票而不落实这项政策。所以我们希望这个选举委员重视这一点，让年轻人能够参与政治，让18岁以上的年轻人能够参与政治。所以在这里我们有两个主张，第一个，如果选举委员会没有办法落实让18岁以上的自动成为选民，那请现任的这一个主席自己辞职，让更有能力的人来推动这个政策。第二点，我们也希望政府能够成立特别调查小组，调查这项的进展，为什么到至今 on track， 而且我们看到所有的报道到至今依然没有办法执行，到底是因为 technical issues， 到底是因为是任何的技术上的问题，还是种种的原因，请让它透明公开的让全马来西亚人民都知道，因为我们有这个权利知道并且了解。谢谢。那我现在会用英文来这一个做这一个 press conference。OK, the parliament has already passed that amendment to lower down the voting age to 18 years old. Yet the elections commission says yesterday they have claimed that much awaits for this Undi 18. Undi 18 will be delayed until September 2022 due to the movement control order and due to the pandemic. With these particular statements, MCAU find that it is very unreasonable and ridiculous. Regarding to this turnout of events, MCAU's opinion is that the EC justification is totally unreasonable. Firstly, how can the EC predict that when is the next elections will be held and the nation still be under the MCO? Also, the EC current task is to update the electoral roll. What does the MCO have to do with this? Is the EC saying that the MCO has been affecting tasks such as this? So the second thing, the amendment to enable Undi 18 received bipartisan from all the member of parliaments, they have already supported this particular bill. Hence, there's no reason to stall it. It also reflects the sentiments of the majority of the youth. So it is the EC responsibility to ensure that this implementation can be done swiftly. The so-called debate whether we should allow or not allow is already gone. Now it is a time for us to implement it. So the EC has to do their job. Thirdly, the EC Deputy Chairman, Dr. Azmi Sharon, has said previously, even under the COVID-19, even under the MCO, the preparations for the Undi 18 registration should be done, should be on track and be done by July 2021, which is this year. The EC latest announcement yesterday obviously have contradicted these particular statements. Hence, we request them to actually clarify on this particular issue so that there will be no confusions. And most importantly, from our youth stand is, for the youth of the country is actually the hope of the nation. Hence, we hope that there will be more youth to participate in politics, participate in the building of these nations. Hence, it is their rights to vote, and it is for our duty to empower them, the rights to vote, and most importantly, we want them to participate of the building of, in building these nations. We also want their voice to be heard, and most importantly, from what we can see in the previous general elections, where we have saw Pakatan Harapan promises PTPTN be abolished, and eventually when they become the government, they did not do so. Hence, is that the reason why when the young voters are not there, when the young people are not the voters, they can simply void their manifesto? So we want more young people to participate. And for young people, there is no political inclinations or there's no political preference to whichever parties. So it's more, even more important for us to hear their voice, for us, for them to participate in building these nations. And we want easy to take immediate actions. So from our MCA youth side, first of all, we would like to ask if the chairman is capable of implementing this particular policy. If the chairman is incapable of doing so, please give way for others. And the second thing is, we would like the government to set up a special task force to investigate and to find out what's happening to this particular process. All Malaysians deserve to know the truth. And enough is enough for all the delays and all the excuses. We want to hear what is the right thing, what is happening now. We want transparency and we want accountability. And with this, I will thanks in my statements, and I'll pass this on to my Youth Civil and Society Movement Bureau Chief, Heng Zili, lawyer. Thank you.
Hello. Thank you, Mr. Li Yen. My name is Heng. I was Zili. Okay. I'm the Bureau Chief of the Civil Society Movement for the Youth Section. So, regarding the statement issued by EC, we are really upset and shocked when we are told that this particular reform on the UNDI 18 should be on track as has been announced by the Deputy Chairman of EC. So, from the technical aspect, we think that there should be no reason that EC could rise as a reason to delay or postpone the entire reform process, because from the aspect of secondary legislation, for example like election conduct of election regulations and any other related regulations, which can be done actually at the level of executive, which means that it does not require, okay, does not require the parliament to pass any bill to actually effective the reform. Secondly, there are some debates regarding the Election Offences Act, whereby people, some academicians might argue that the Election Offences Act would trigger or require to be amended. And in my opinion, it does not be necessary, because the only section which involved required any enactment is actually the part which mentioned about the agent of the candidate, right? That require the agent to be aged at least 21 years old. So we think this is not necessary and it can be done later. So it can be done after the parliament session has been restored. And for the technical issue, for example, like the registration, automatic registration of voters for age above 18, we believe it can be done easily as well, especially during this very advanced technology. With the advance of technology, it can be done easily by synchronizing the IC information through JPN, Jabatan Pendaftaran Negara. And this can be done easily, and the Election Commission should not giving such an excuse if like that the data cannot be synchronized or there's difficulties in locating the voters or to put them in certain area or constituency. So we think this action postponing or giving reasons to delay the reform is actually depriving the constitutional right of each of our voters, especially those has achieved 18 years old. So we urge the EC to look into this matter seriously, and we urge the government to take initiative to monitor the entire reform. That's our stance, and we open the question to the floor.
Okay. 那重复一次，那刚刚我们的这个
发言人李议员同志呢，刚刚就说了我们的这个马青的立场。那至于这一个技术层面的部分，我们相信说这一个选委会不应该以有技术的这一个问题来推延，或者是不执行这一个国家已经批准的这一个法案，也就是说刚刚的这个修宪。那这个本身第一，许多的这些选举的这些条规其实都是属于次级的 ，OK， subsidiary registration， OK， 次级的这一个立法，这不需要通过国会来执行，它只需要通过在选委会内部提称的这些法案修改，然后交由相关的部门去批准执行就行了。所以我们觉得这一个部分呢，不能够当作是一个借口和理由去拖延整个选委会的这一个改革，温迪十八跟自动选民登记的这个改革。那另外刚刚还有提到这个，还有许多外面呢有一些学者可能认为说 Election Offenses Act这一个部分可能会受到影响，因为它是一个法规，它是一个法案，需要通过国会来修改。那我们的看法是觉得这个 Election Offenses Act 里面有一个 section 就是关于到这一个候选人的代表，给候选人代表是要21岁以上，那我觉得这一个不是一个太重要的一个问题，可以在过后国会来临通过的时候呢，我们再来通过，就是说等国会复会再通过也不迟。那这基本上不会影响我们的这一个18岁跟自动成为登记选民的这一个问题的存在。那第三就是关于这个技术，另外一个技术问题就是说我们的这个选民册的问题。那选民册基本上可以通过现在的现有科技，可以很容易的通过技术来把这个选民册的资料从国民登记局移到这个我们的选举委员会，而通过 IC 上面的这个地址，我们也能够马上确认该选民是在哪一个选区投票的。所以我不觉得这些都是推迟或者是展延温迪十八在七月来临的七月执行的一个问题。所以我们觉得说我们公民社会运动局，马青公民社会运动局认为这一项决定，尤其是选委会这一个 official statement， 它其实就是剥夺了我们已经成为18岁或者是已经18岁的这些选民的这些公民的权利这是一个违宪的一个决定。所以我们觉得我们马青我们希望政府跟这个选委会要重视这个课题，然后我们希望他们能够兑现他们承诺，在七月完全的推展这个温迪十八的这个还有自动登记选民的这个措施。谢谢。
来你先。
像你们除了这些主张以外，你们有一些比较 proactive 的对策吗？
对，在接下来的这一个举动，我们将会有这一个收集这一个意见，并且会呈上这一个备忘录给这一个选举委员会，并且呈上这一个备忘录给这一个政府部门。
可以具体讲一下是哪一些部门
吗？我们会去这一个
Election Commission
我们会呈这一个备忘录给这个 Election Commissions， 然后过后我们会呈这一个备忘录给这一个
YB 大概有点那个地方们了。
So just to be clear, the Election Offenses Act is talking about candidate only, not
candidates.
Agents of candidates.
The part
related to age 21 is actually related to the agents of the candidate, which require the agent of candidate to be at 10 21 years old, yes.
But not the voter.
Yeah, not the
voter. Not the candidate as well. Any other questions?
Yeah, any other question, can we just open to the floor to ask about the UNDI 18th and also the automatic registration of voters.
If no questions, okay.
If no questions, then we'll end our PC then. And thank you for all. Thank you for coming on. And over here, we would like to hold the banners to show that our determination is implementing these flexible policies.